The JWST is humanity's newest and most advanced method of peering deep into the cosmos, all the way back into the time immediately following the Big Bang. The telescope is 100 times more powerful than Hubble and can capture longer infrared wavelengths, allowing it to see distant or highly redshifted galaxies. Looking further into the distance means looking back in time. So JWST is effectively looking at the beginning of time and space by seeking the most primitive stars and galaxies. In this video, we will see the terrifying new structures discovered by the James Webb Space Telescope. So, without further ado, let's begin. NASA's space telescopes have discovered thousands of new planets beyond our solar system over the last few decades. However, astronomers had to wait for the next generation of advanced observatories to get a closer look at these exoplanets to see if they might get a look into life's building blocks. One such next-generation telescope is NASA's long-awaited James Webb Space Telescope, and it's already delivered the results after only a few months of official science operations. Deep in the early universe, NASA's James Webb Space Telescope is revealing previously unseen galaxies. JWST was recently pointed at an object known as MACS-0647-JD by astronomers. Because light takes time to travel, looking at such a distant object is also like looking back in time. MAC-50647-JD can be traced back to the Big Bang, or within the first 400 million years of the universe. Dan Coe of the Space Telescope Science Institute discovered it with the Hubble Space Telescope, which was previously NASA's most powerful space observatory 10 years ago. Astronomers discovered new features of one of the oldest galaxies ever seen by comparing the new JWST image to prior Hubble imagery. Both Hubble and the JWST use gravitational lensing to study the early universe. That's what happens when a massive cluster of distant galaxies warp spacetime, bending light from galaxies far in the distance behind it. This produces mirror images of those galaxies, which are reflected back at us. As a result, the mysterious MAC-0647-JD system's imprint appears in three places in the images above. Breakouts of those three JD system images show how much clearer JWST's images are. They clearly depict two distinct objects. Birth of a star. This image depicts baby stars that were previously hidden from our view in a stellar nursery, a region where new stars are born. The Carina Nebula, a star-forming region in the Milky Way, is the focal point. Despite this, the Webb image reveals hundreds of new stars and cosmic structures that, honestly, we don't even know what they are, according to Amber Straun, JWST's deputy project scientist who presented the image. Deep field. The light from stars and galaxies in this image dates back more than 13 billion years. The Big Bang occurred 13.8 billion years ago, so this image depicts a moment not long after time began. Because the gravity of clusters warps what's behind them, an effect known as lensing, some objects appear smudged because they're magnified. Galaxies. This is an image of Stephen's Quintet, a close group of galaxies discovered by Edward Stephen in 1877. There are five in the photo, but it is a visual trick. One of the galaxies is approximately 400 million light years away from Earth, but the other four are a true compact grouping, all of which are located between 210 million and 340 million light years away. In some ways, it's a photograph that transports us from the nearby modern universe to the ancient universe. Exoplanet. This is an indirect image. This is essentially the raw set because visual images from space are frequently reconstructed from light data. While it is not as visually appealing as the deep field, it contains a wealth of data for scientists. This is the spectrum of the gas giant exoplanet WASP-96b, which is 1,120 light years away from Earth. Bumps and wiggles indicate water vapor in the atmosphere. In the future, there will be a lot more data like this from other planets and asteroids. Star death. This is a highly detailed near-infrared image of the Southern Ring, a nebula caused by a dying star 2,500 light-years away. The nebula's foamy ring is caused by molecular hydrogen produced by the massive explosion. The rays are actually holes in the inner nebula that allow light from the star to pass through. The nebula's center contains two stars. Scientists knew the Southern Ring was a binary star system, but we can now see them clearly. The Sparkler Galaxy. The image, known as SMACS-0723, is an example of what is known as a gravitational lens. It depicts a group of massive foreground galaxies that have magnified and bent light from background galaxies. One particularly lovely galaxy in the far distance has piqued the interest of astronomers at the University of Toronto. It's called the Sparkler Galaxy because it's surrounded by small yellow-red dots known as sparkles. James Webb's extraordinary abilities can only connect these dots. You couldn't see them with Hubble or any other great observatory. The Toronto team initially wondered if the sparkles had anything to do with the Sparkler Galaxy. Was it possible they were just sitting out there by themselves, a long way ahead or behind the sparkler? The Sparkler Galaxy is projected three times in the SMASC-0723 image, indicating they were linked. That's how gravitational lenses work. They can magnify background objects while distorting and multiplying their appearance. The same dots can be found in all three versions of the Sparkler Galaxy. The team contends that the sparkles are globular clusters similar to those seen around our Milky Way today, except that we see these dots much earlier in the universe's history. We see the sparkler 9 billion years ago, or approximately 4.5 billion years after the Big Bang. We are finding these globular clusters to be very massive. Dr. Lamaya Moala of Toronto's Dunlop Institute for Astrology and Astrophysics explained, they are also very old in our opinion. They could have formed in a burst around 10 billion years ago at what we call cosmic noon, the peak of star formation. However, their color is incorrect. We're finding that they're much redder than we expected them to be, which means they must be older. Even at that very early time, she told BBC News. According to the team, the stars in these globular sparkles formed only a few hundred million years after the Big Bang. According to astronomers, the sparkles may contain some of the very first stars to form in the universe. And when we first opened the SMACS image, we too were looking for the farthest things. And then we were literally sidetracked by the most gleaming object. Based in Toronto, the Canadian NIRISS Unbiased Cluster Survey will now look at five more gravitationally lensed views from James Webb, similar to the SMACS image. That's really going to push up the number of galaxies that we find with sparkles around them, said Dunlop Institute fellow Dr. Karthik Iyer. We'd like to know how common these sparkles are. Did we just discover a unique galaxy, or can we expect to see more of this once we have a representative sample from the web? He told BBC News. JWST could also reveal galaxy mergers and other previously unseen activity in the early universe. JWST is expected to discover even more distant galaxies from the very beginning of the universe. This will help scientists reconstruct the history of the Earth's first 400 million years. And that brings us to the end of today's video. Do you think JWST will be able to discover new life during this time? Let us know in the comments below. If you liked the video, please leave a like and a comment below. Also, if you're new to this channel, subscribe and click the notification bell to get notified when we upload more content.